This is Dennis Brown. We're live at Thinkspace. It's my first mini solo show, Day Low and Number. Yeah, as far as my background, like, I was born in the Philippines. My dad's in the Air Force, grew up in the military, so, like, I'm not really from anywhere. It's kind of, I have, like, a range of areas where I grew up, mostly out in the Pacific. Came to the States in 2001 to go to school in Florida. Did a BFA in illustration. Just kind of like a cliche niche in relation to like what's presented, you know? So it's like, I always feel like, you know, it's like, why do all the black paintings have to like come from like Africa or something, you know? It's like, why can't it be like contemporary and like current, like, you know, or why can't it be mixed in with like sci-fi or something, you know? So it's like, I like to try to present a different perspective on like ethnic oriented stuff. And it's like, you don't see a lot of it out there, you know? So it's like, you know, why not try to present it in that fashion? I'm just like really fascinated with a range of things, you know? Like, I mean, as far as drawing and creating imagery, like that's just always been a fascination of mine since I was like a really, you know, youngin' or whatnot. So it's like, for the most part, it's always been with me. Like, I always knew that I wanted to take it a little bit further, you know? So if anything, like, my main aim, like coming out of high school, was like, yeah, I want to go to art school and see what that has to offer, you know. So, pretty much when I went to art school, that's when I really figured out, like, wow, like, there's a lot you can really do with this, and there's a lot, you know, you can really take it to so many different directions. I spent a lot of time like studying, like other artists and like studying different genres and seeing like what's out there. Everything from like, you know, contemporary art to commercial art to illustration to like anything involving image making, you know. It's like, I don't limit myself, because it's like, why, you know, why would you? Like, I try to incorporate like a lot of nostalgic oriented content, also stuff that's like, I don't know, figurative mixed with like outer worldly content. Yeah, as far as the people in my imagery, a lot of them are kind of like Frankenstein references that I use. Like, there's like all these people aren't existing, you know? So they're just, I don't know. Like, a lot of it's like with my head mixed with like references. So it's not necessarily, they're not necessarily like real or whatever. So yeah. So this particular piece, it was just, I just wanted to experiment with more so the medium and just figure out like how it works. The imagery just kind of just came as is. A lot of the time I don't really plan out my pieces. They kind of just come to be. So like with this piece, I started out with the face, and the face pretty much trendsetted the rest of the piece. They just came out and then just composed it as is. But I guess with this, like, it started out with just like a sketch that I just came up with one night. So I started working it out, and then like I said, a lot of times I work really spontaneous, so it kind of just comes to me. But as I was working into it, I found, I guess, relatives to some nostalgic things or whatnot, where it was like, I kind of saw this piece as like a group of friends that I had like growing up, where like, you know, I guess just kids in general, they have a tendency to play fight. You know, a lot of times you just see them like fighting or like doing like random like fighting moves, but you know, a lot of times, like, what are they fighting, you know? So this particular piece, like, it's kind of like a shout out to like my friends that I grew up with, and we used to like pretend like we had superpowers or like superhero abilities. So so this particular piece is more like our interpretation of us with these powers, like through our eyes, in a sense. And as far as like all the masks, like that's, it kind of keeps it anonymous in that sense, where it's like, you know, it keeps you wondering like, yeah, who are these people, or like what's going on? As far as like the guy with the football helmet, like he's obviously like more of like like in every group, there's always like a leader figure. So it's like, you see the mask like floating off in air, and it's obviously the guy with the helmet, it's like, you know, throwing it behind him, because it's like, you know, I'm the leader or whatever. I guess with this particular piece, like the name of it is called, Thelonious and the Children of Ego, and Thelonious is obviously the main character. And as far as like the Children of Ego are like all the different characters that are surrounding him. You know, everybody has their everybody has an ego and whatnot. So like this is kind of like my interpretation of like different people's egos and how like egos come in different shapes and sizes. And a lot of the times, like, an ego could be pretty monstrous, just because it's like it's very very self-centered in that sense. And and considering that there's always somebody there to feed people's egos, so like this is one of those characters. So like he's obviously holding a bow, right? So everybody's gathering around. It's like, oh, it's feeding time or whatever. And the fact that you can see the different sizes, it's like, you know, like I said, going back to different people's ego. Like some people's are more monstrous than others, and then some people have like little egos, you know. And a lot of times the egos start out really small, but you know, the more they feed them, obviously the more they grow. So and like I said, that the variation just relates to, you know, the variation in people and, you know, different backgrounds and such like that. But I think with this particular piece, I incorporated Jordan 3s. And for the most part, like, I'm pretty big into collecting shoes or whatever, so this is kind of like a shout out. I mean, it's like, if you know, you know. So it's like a shout out to like shoe collectors, like, hey, like, I know what's up. You know, so. And it's pretty interesting too, because like, you know, some like, I guess when certain people see this, it's like, just kind of like inviting, I guess, people that wouldn't normally look at this type of stuff to like, it gives them a connection to some degree, you know, because it's like, oh, like, I see he's rocking J3s or whatever. So it's like they feel like, you know, there's like some type of connection there to a certain degree. Like more and more of my recent pieces, I try to do stuff along those lines where I'm either incorporating content of my interest or nostalgic orientated stuff, also coming with like a different perspective. Like I said, just push the envelope a little bit further to see how far I can really take it as far as image making. So this is Dennis Brown, meet you live at Thinkspace. It's my first mini solo show, Thalo and Umber. Yeah, thanks to Lava Magazine. Appreciate your interest. Hope what I said was somewhat interesting and inspiring. Drop me a line through bagger43.com. Feel free to check that out in your time, you know, spare time and whatnot. bagger43.com. I also have like a link on my blog on there, Bags Blog, Lava Magazine. They're doing some pretty inspiring stuff, so yeah, go and check them out. Thanks again, and have a good one.